27 teams in the men's category. And there's 13 in the women. These odd numbers create a little bit of problem for us. But we're going with your assistance and especially Houghton, we'll try and manage this as best as we can so that we can have a really good event. There are some things that I just need to go over with you so that some principles with regard to the draw itself. Provincially, in the men's category, Gauteng has 12 teams, KZN 6, Western Cape 3, Limpopo 2, Free State 1, and Mpumalanga 1. And in the women's section, you have 8 from Gauteng, 2 from KZN, Western Cape, Limpopo, Free State, and Mpumalanga. Sorry, 7 from
Gauteng. Just a quick question. Just to confirm, all teams have been accepted for all
teams. Yes, we're not dropping anybody. So 7 in Gauteng, 2 in KZN, Western Cape, Limpopo, Free State, and Mpumalanga, 1 in Gauteng. Like I said, there's some principles that we're going to use to, in order to see place the teams. The first one is that, if you'll recall last year's tournament, we had, we had 15 teams in the men. We played the quarterfinals, semifinals, and finals. So we know who came out in the first four, and then who came out in the next four, and after that. So there are some teams from last year's competition, quite a few of them. So the first thing is that we're going to see in the men's category, we're going to see the first four teams as per the results of the tournament. Because we have 27 teams in the men, we are going to group them into 8 groups. In Then we are instead we're doing two. Okay, sorry guys. It's 25 teams. The two that are indicated that are going to participate and then did not control participation or maybe something like that. So that's why we're down to 25. So we divided into 8 groups. The first 7 groups are 3 teams. And the 8th group with 4 teams. We play a round robin system per group. Then we play, take the top 2. We have a round of 16. Then the quarterfinals, then the semifinal, third and fourth at the final. That's what we do. Okay? Then, like I said, in the men's category, the first 4 teams are seeded from A group A to group D. We take the quarterfinalists from the last year's championship. So, and we will see them from a place in the group. That would take out, I think, 2 teams in counting. We left with 10 teams in counting. The second round, second tier, will draw the 10 teams from counting. We take 8 and we place it into H. Balance of the teams, people. Gauteng will have 2, KZN will have 2, Limpopo 1, Western Cape 2, Free State 1, and Mpumalanga 1. Then we'll draw. All 2 Western Cape, 2 KZN, and groups B to D. Then you will be counting the important three states, you put them together and you draw them in the next. From E going around to H, and then the last group will have the extra. What it will do is that it will avoid A group having 3 teams from counting. In a group of 3, we'll have all counting teams in one group. We do it the way it's set. If all groups will just have 2 teams.
You should ask a question. So you must know there's P teams that are not here will ask lots of questions. So is it forming a format to play internationally, or is it something that you're suggesting that the way we should do it?
I don't think we have to do
that. We see CABB.
CABB does if you draw. Let's say you draw in group A, and if there's a team in group A from your same group, then they move you over to the other side.
So it's good for the same country.
From the same country.
From the same
country. From the same
country.
From the same country.
Region.
From the same region.
Okay, so it's good to confirm that because you're recording it so people will know that this is how CAB does it and it's the way to do it.
Because you must know it's at that level, most countries in group A, if you have 2 groups, the defending champion in group B, and then if you draw, if they're from the same zone, if they don't fall in the same group, you move them over to the other side. Just to avoid you, because you may end up, like I said, more teams, or more groups may have teams from counting. Agreed? want me to tell you how the woman's going to be done now?
Yes, correct.
Do the men first and then the woman?
Yes, tell us now.
Tell you now. Women has got 7 from Gauteng, 2 from KZN, 1 from Mozambique, 1 from Limpopo, 1 from Free State, 1 from Mpumalanga. That gives you 13 teams. The top 4 teams as per 2017 results, they seeded, there's 4 groups.
4 groups?
Yes. Seeded 1 to 4. Let me put balance of the Gauteng teams. Together, remember, those 2 teams, Gauteng teams, and your first team. That's on Group B and Group B. You take the balance of the Gauteng teams, we draw 4 places from Group A to D. So they can take care of 6 Gauteng teams.
On the rule on avoiding teams from the same group, from the same region, have you taken into consideration the fact that the champions were actually from Gauteng?
Yes.
And when you go to level 2 and you put Gauteng first, it means you will have another team from Gauteng facing the champion. If you go to number 9 and 10 under the same rule, you also go to Gauteng team again.
Let me finish, then you will see that you'll only have, the most you'll have is 2 teams from Gauteng in a group in the leagues. Because you're going to have 3 groups with 3 teams each. You have the same problem again where you may have a group with 3 Gauteng teams. Right? So, you'll have Group B and Group D will have 2 Gauteng teams each, right? Then, if we draw, Gauteng can fall into the one Gauteng team that's left, can be drawn into Group A or to Group C, because in those 2 groups you only have 1 Gauteng team. Right? Then you draw the rest. Rest of the teams will be drawn into Group B, Group B, and then last one in Group D. But we also have to ensure that the 2 teams from KZN don't fall into the same group. Everybody? We're going to do the ladies first.
Thank you, sir.
Group A is Campbell's. Group B, VUT. Group C, Group B. Group B is VUT. Group C is UWC, Group D is Quantum. Senior team from last year. Okay, we're going to write the next of the Quantum teams. We're going to put 2, 4, 5 together. TUT is 1, we're going to draw.
Draw.
Wits.
Beatmasters.
Where is
the PUT? PUT? Bad news.
That is very bad news.
That news are from the Free State.
Very bad news there. Well, the quarterfinalists, there's only three remaining from the four quarterfinals. One is not playing. Those three, DUT, Liberat, UKZN. When you go further down and you look at the results, you end up with another two KZN teams. In terms of the scores, Falcon makes you the higher. So, and we draw those four teams, the groups, each edge.
going to try to pass.
I thought you said you're seeding them.
No, we didn't play.
No playoffs.
We didn't have playoffs with them in terms of 5, 6, 7, 8. But they are the team that ended in the quarterfinals.
Who was the team that?
Arsenal Saints.
Yeah.
All okay. Now, the other two teams that the place that I'm taking the four, other two will put them in there. Right. Guys, UKZN, Maidstone, Libra, and the UT.
We are now more experienced. There you go.
Group A.
Pitmasters. Eagles. Eagles.
Group B.
Group B. Vikings. Group C. Celtic. Group D. Falcons,
there's also in Group C you got the same problem. And G.
Group C.
You got three VUT, Tux and Vikings. So what you should do is Vikings move over to D, Celtic moves over to E. And then you draw down and the last team then falls into C.
Yes, Vikings are supposed to move into group.
We said it moves to the next group. That's what we're doing.
We said we're moving. If we see, we'll move it to the next group.
Yes.
What's the run of group C?
Vikings will move to group E.
We'll move to group E.
No, but all the rest of the groups all have KZN team.
No, you move Celtic to the one before that.
So you Celtic will be C and Vikings will be D.
Falcons is E. Bad news.
He's not breaking any rules.
we see?
Lions.
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 The last one.
The last one.
So we should have just put it in there.
Group A, UJ, Delphos, Beatmasters. Group B, Templates, TUT, and Eagles. Group C, VUT, Tucks and Celtics. Group D, Spikers.
UWC Spikers.
UWC first. UWC Spikers and Vikings. Group E, DUT, PMVC.
Falcons.
Falcons. Group F, Liberat, SMU, Bad News. Group G, Maidstone, Wits, and Lions. Group H, UKZN, Quantum, and University of Limpopo. Again, guys? Right. Yes.
You're always going to have that.
I'm going to have some. We will send out the groupings and the fixtures. During the course of the week, hopefully by Monday, it will also be put on the website. Yes, sir.
I've just got one question. In your playoffs, is it A1 versus D2?
Men or women?
Men or women?
A1, B2, A2, B1. C1, B2, C2, B1. Quarterfinal. Semi-final. Those four games in that order, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 will play 4, 2 will play 3. Losers play the third and fourth.
Yeah,
I'm
okay. Yes.
A1 versus B2.
It's in the comments, man. Yeah. A will play B, C will play D.
C will play D. Then you get 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, 2, 3, 4.
And then A will play 1 will versus 4.
1 and 4, 2.
That's all I want.
And the female publishing manual also doesn't talk about women who are still under 16.
Yeah.
So how does it work? So what have you got?
Round of 16 guys for the men.
Yeah.
A, B, C and E, E and F, G and H. Right? That's your round of 16. Any quarterfinals? 1-8, 2-7, 3-6.
Your seeds are going to play each other in round of 16. That's what it's coming out.
Oh.
Isn't it supposed to be A versus group H?
Yeah.
No.
Remember, one is playing 8. 8 is your G and H. When is your G and H?
Rama 16?
No.
Not in Rama 16. Not in Rama 16. I'm saying Rama 16 is different because not Rama 16, you got group
if
A.
If you take, for example, let's just take example, A1 is UJ. They win their group. They'll play the drawn team from the second team. Who's an unseen?
No, not unseen. Because you got here from.
It,
It should be going to eight.
If your second team loses and they come down, then they'll play.
Automatically, when you have your system, like, you always have in a group, number eight is with number eight. Right? If you're playing the way you normally play, your number eight is always with eight. So in this one, it should be 16 in this one rather than number eight.
So, sorry, Devo, what it means is seeding 1 to 4 becomes a curse rather than an advantage.
That's what you do.
Because you by doing it that way, you have put number one and number two in the same path.
Yeah. In the same path in a
before 16. The final.
In the round of 16.
In the round of 16. Instead of they playing number one playing number eight, it should be number one should be playing number 16. Because it should be the eight team they should be playing in that pool. So you must just
that
have a look.
That would only work if you all the teams were seeded.
Yeah.
Well, you seeded eight.
Only when all the teams were seeded. If, for example, next year we have 32 teams and they're all seeded, or if we have the 24 and they're all seeded 1 to 24, then what you say we can make the
just have a look, if you're putting them on the same
path. What it means, Diva, is
C and D, you're putting on the same path.
Somewhere along the line, number 1 and 2 are going to meet maybe in the semis or quarters using this method, which I don't think is what we intend.
Well, only if the second seed loses in the round robin, come second, they'll meet the first seed. Otherwise, they only meet in the round. Yeah, I mean, this is before, guys. See, we haven't changed it. Right, guys, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Wish you well. And Gauteng, please. We're going to be here on Wednesday next week. That leaves us with only 5 days. We're going to look at, well, of course, I spoke to him, he's going to sort out marking of the court and thing. Number one, of course, we'll send you the list of your trust that you have, the scoreboard, the flags. If there's anything that you don't have, please let me know. I don't want to carry everything from there into here, if you have it. If something you don't have, talk to us, then we can carry some of them. Then, of course, the court marking. I don't know whether you have pole covers pushing. I'm just worried because you have also the bench is going to be on this side and the bench is going to be on the far end, and the one in the middle is going to have the bench. People are going to be running in and out of things like that. I don't know whether you have an extra court if needed, but I should have work out by tonight. Tomorrow at the latest, exactly how the fixtures are going to look. Now that it has gone this way, we're probably in the men. We'll finish the round robin in 2 days. Round of 16, the third day. Quarterfinal, semifinal on the fourth day. The third and fourth day, and the final on the fifth day, which is the Monday. Right. And the ladies
What time are you expecting? I believe the guy from that set that got the net, I check out his books, there is hook, I can see it in the book there for the balls going to fall around. Can they be up here as well?
Only danger with the net.
They slip.
They run onto the net and they slip. You're going to be worse than the injury and the bumping
in the one side. Thing is that you're still playing a good match and then the ball rolls onto the court. They have to make a choice.
Yes. Let's have that much away from the floor. You know what happened in the book. It could be a series. But I don't know. Would the net say, does it really look
just
for
you?
Yes?
No? No, I'm going to say something.
We have plenty of things. We have to be at the end.
The interactions will be there, but as minimal as they will do.
During your start time,
guys,
your start time.
Half a seat.
Sorry. So, and your end time is going to go till the end because you're going to finish the game.
We're going to finish. We'll have
last game.
Now that we have 24 games we can play, 6 a day. So, if we start at 9 o'clock, then 6 games a day, and each court will be 12, 2 days, 24. So, should finish by 8 and 9, depending on whether the game gets longer.
And the venue is all here.
I'm going to work out, I'll speak to Mr. Bonanzi if we need an extra card.
Maybe Diva, we can still put it to the out-end police for that one court. Let's just, if there's a one court available somewhere, we put fillers around to just get the one coach.
You see, with the ladies, we have 3, 6, 9, 15 games. So it makes it easier, no, don't worry. We'll do it.
We can do everything.
Yes, sir.
I'm just diverting from this draw thing. But I wanted to ask one question. I know it's maybe for next week, but probably next week it will be too late. On your manual, you said you need maximum of 12 players.
10.
No, maximum.
Maximum 10, yes.
Maximum
10. Maximum 10.
Yes, but internationally, we're going for 14. So I wanted to know if a team has got players to make it 14 with 2 defenders. Is that a problem?
It is a problem.
There's no international.
Only World Championship and Olympic Games allow 14.
On the contrary, then you allow 2 liberos.
Yes.
2 liberos is a system for 40,
exactly.
Not for 12.
Yes.
International.
The document tells you 10 plus 2, 11 plus 1, 12 plus 0.
And it says your document says 2 liberos.
Oh, international document.
Okay.
International. Okay. Can I see you?